This video is about how I spend $10 for 3 meals in Singapore. Hello everyone, my name is Terence and welcome to the first episode of Share Like You Minute. You see, hawker culture in Singapore was successfully inscribed as Singapore's first element on the UNESCO representative list in 2020. Hawker culture in Singapore is at the heart of everyday life, where people gather at hawker centers to dine and bond over food prepared by hawkers. Number 1. Huat Lee Eating House is located at 1001 Yishun Industrial Park A, right across Canberra MRT.
Hello! What do we have?
Yes.
$2 only, huh? $2. Okay, wait. Add a bit more.
$2.
Yes, $2. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, uncle.
Okay.
Okay, so as you guys know, right, I'm on this $10 challenge for this Saturday. So at the very first stop, I could only afford two prata, two kosong prata for just $2. Okay, so apparently it's from this Zam Zam Indian special food. Very long queue, so I really have to taste how is it going to be like. Okay, but my friend here,
yes,
Wilbur,
yes.
Can you tell us what do you have?
Same. Prata, but just that I added $1 of baldi.
Oh, show them. What's
see?
The baldi?
Okay, this baldi.
Okay.
Taste like that.
Yeah,
oh my god,
it's
so nice. Oh,
this is hilarious. Okay, so let's tuck in. Mm. Okay.
I did not join the $10 because I know that my breakfast is going to be worth the $10.
Yeah, that kind of friend he is, right? Thanks Lloyd for joining me. Very spontaneous. It was a very last minute call, but he was able to join us this morning. A few more cents left for my morning coffee.
Wow.
Okay, I think I'm screwed, man, seriously. As usual, I never check price when I order and I forgot that I'm on this challenge. So this cup of coffee cost me $1.20. I'm dead. I think I got the ration for my lunch later. Or are you going to help me pay for this?
Well, I can, but I don't think you want me to.
Yeah, I think that's totally not the spirit of this challenge. Okay, so I was just contemplating whether should I just return the kopi si siu tai. But I think I shouldn't because coffee to me is very important and it's a long day ahead. So I think I will manage the expenses accordingly for my lunch and my dinner.
Yeah,
cheers. Okay, so now that we have finished our coffee, I think it's timely to, you know, just ask ourselves whether is this place worth recommending to you guys. So yeah, will for anything.
Definitely worth recommending. The food is very nice. It's cheap also, and there's a lot of crowd here that speaks for itself. I think I will come back here again. We try out so many other stores that I want to try.
Yeah, indeed, I think I really missed out a lot of good food. I think especially the balde that Lloyd actually tried earlier on. So I think I will come back for that. I think the other very popular one that we saw was the Tong Sin vegetarian food.
Ah, yes. That one still got a lot of queue now. I think the food is quite freshly prepared also. So definitely go and try it again.
Yes. Okay. We have come to the end of the first stop, the breakfast stop. So yes, thank you Wilbur for joining us.
Yes, thank you. I'm going home to do more work.
Yes. Well, I'm going to eat more. Alright, see you in the next stop.
Bye-bye.
Number 2. Jurong West 505 Market and Food Centre. Thanks to Peter for recommending this bustling hawker centre to me. Soki Cooked Foods serves super tender chicken and comforting Cantonese porridge in this food centre. Okay, so finally I'm now at 505 Jurong West Food Centre. Okay, so I've ordered myself this soggy chicken rice, chicken porridge, I beg your pardon. So thanks to the recommendation of Peter. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank
and thanks for your recommendation.
No problem.
So what are you having?
I'm having this Penang prawn noodle.
Okay.
So looks good from the outside. So far not too bad.
Okay. So I'm very hungry already. Coming from all the way from the northeast now. Time to dig in.
Number 3. Bedok 85. Special shout out to all my friends who highly recommended this hawker in the east to be featured in this vlog. Seng Hiang Ba Chor Mee store stands out for its divine and soupy bowl of Ba Chor Mee that is well cooked without a strong alkaline taste of the usual egg noodles. The broth has a balanced seasoning with fatty minced pork and lard to provide quite a pleasant dining experience.
So many of you have recommended the Ba Chor Mee, so I have ordered the Ba Chor Mee from this store called Seng Hiang. So I think it's highly rated because of the soup broth. So I'm going to try it, and it's only like $3. I like the texture of the noodles. It's very chewy, very QQ. So very different from the usual yellow noodles, which has a lot of, you know, the ghee flavor. Okay, so the essence is really the rou yuan. Very good. I think they definitely have included the bian yu inside, such that it has a very flavorful taste to it. Alright, so once again, thank you so much for all your recommendations, and with that, see you in the next episode.
The $10 challenge for 3 meals is definitely possible in Singapore. But with more friends, I'm sure you are able to enjoy more varieties. My greatest takeaway for this $10 challenge was experiencing the friendliness of the store owners. Auntie and uncles, thank you so much for making my day. Do let me know what you think about our hawker culture as well as recommendations by leaving a comment down below. Do remember to like, share and subscribe if you like content like this. I shall see you in the next episode of Share Like You Minute. Bye!